You wouldn't expect a shootout to happen at an event with Jeff Bezos and Leonardo DiCaprio, but at an after party for a Justin Bieber concert, there was a shooting that left 4 people injured, including Kodak Black. Here's what went down. On Friday night, Bieber put on a private show for an audience full of A-list celebrities. The guest list included huge names like Drake, Khloe Kardashian, and Tobey Maguire. The after party was held at a popular Hollywood restaurant called The Nice Guy, which is where the shooting happened later that night. Around 3 a.m., Kodak, Gunna, and Lil Baby were standing on the street outside of the party. At first, it looks like everything is cool and they're all just hanging out. Then, out of nowhere, a fight broke out and Kodak swung at someone. Seconds later, shots started popping off and everyone scattered. TMZ posted a video of the fight that shows a dude wearing black who looks like he's holding a pistol. It's not clear if he's actually the shooter or who he was there with, but police are investigating the situation. 3 other people besides Kodak was hit, including a 60-year-old man, but none of the injuries was life-threatening, and they're all in stable condition. The story's still developing, but according to Kodak's camp, he's trying to defend his homie. A source told TMZ that someone in Kodak's crew got jumped after they stepped outside the party. Kodak threw himself into the fight and attacked the dude who jumped his friend, and that's when someone started letting off shots. It's not clear if the shooter was the same dude who jumped Kodak's friend or someone else, but Kodak ended up getting hit in the leg and taken to the hospital. We don't know much about his injury, but he's listed in stable condition, so it seems like he's gonna pull through. No one expected something like this to go down at a Justin Bieber party, but Kodak is no stranger to trouble. He has a long criminal history that started way before he was famous. He started rapping in elementary school and used to record his songs at a trap house after school. He was always getting into fights as a kid and got expelled in the 5th grade. Plus, he was arrested for stealing a car while still in middle school. But despite how much trouble he was getting into, Kodak had a passion for music. He later said in an interview that he had two options: sell drugs with a gun on his hip, or rap. So, when he was 12 years old, he joined a rap group, and a few years later, he dropped his first mixtape. By 2015, Kodak was already building a buzz, but then his career went to the next level after Drake posted a video of himself dancing to one of his songs. When one of the world's biggest artists co-signs you, people start to pay attention. The same month Drake posted the video, Kodak signed with Atlantic Records, and the rest is history. Even though his career was starting to blow up, Kodak couldn't stay out of trouble with the law. The same month he signed his deal with Atlantic Records, he was arrested in Florida for robbery, battery, false imprisonment of a child, and possession of cannabis, but was later released. Then, in April 2016, he was charged with possession of a weapon by a convicted felon, possession of marijuana, and fleeing from officers. Kodak allegedly tried to escape the cops after a drug deal, and afterwards, they caught him trying to throw his gun into a dumpster. 1 month later, he was arrested again on open warrants for armed robbery and false imprisonment. In June, he was added to XXL's 2016 freshman class alongside other superstars like 21 Savage, Lil Yachty, and Lil Uzi Vert. But just 2 months later, he was placed on house arrest after pleading no contest to his robbery, false imprisonment, and marijuana charges. His lawyer argued that Kodak was trying to turn his life around through music, so the judge let him tour internationally, even on house arrest. But while he was in jail, police found out he had 2 outstanding warrants, one for alleged felony criminal sexual conduct in South Carolina, and 2 misdemeanor marijuana charges from Florida. He pleaded no contest to the drug charges and was sentenced to 4 months in jail. After he served his time in Florida, he was taken to South Carolina to face his criminal sexual conduct case. He was originally looking at a maximum of 30 years if he was convicted, but in 2021, he took a plea deal and the charges was dropped to first degree assault and battery, so he was only sentenced to 18 months of probation. During all of his legal issues and controversies, Kodak never stopped working on his career. He dropped multiple albums and collabed with big artists like Juice WRLD, Travis Scott, and NLE Choppa in between stints in jail. But then, in 2018, it looked like the rapper might face serious time after he was arrested on 7 felony charges. The charges came after an Instagram Live video showed him smoking weed and holding a gun around a little kid. He was hit with child neglect, grand theft of a firearm, possession of a firearm by a convicted felon, and more. 3 of the charges were later dropped, then Kodak pleaded not guilty to the others and was sentenced to 364 days in jail. After that, things settled down for a while until April 2019 when he was arrested at the US-Canada border after authorities found weed and a gun in his car. 1 week later, the FBI searched one of his tour buses and arrested some of his crew when they found weapons inside. At this point, it was clear that the cops wanted Kodak off the streets. Just 1 month later, they arrested him right before he was set to perform at Rolling Loud. He was charged with 2 counts of making a false statement on a governmental form. According to prosecutors, Kodak lied about his past criminal record and current indictments while purchasing guns from a legal dealer in Hialeah, Florida. Eventually, he accepted a plea deal for 46 months in prison. In March 2020, he pleaded guilty to the gun case from when he was arrested at the border. The situation wasn't looking good for him, but then in January 2021, he was granted a last-minute pardon by President Trump. Besides all the legal issues he's had over the years, Kodak's been in all kinds of other controversies. In 2017, he was streaming on Instagram Live and showed himself in a hotel room with a bunch of other dudes while one female performed oral sex on all of them. He came under fire again the same year after he posted on Instagram about how he liked light-skinned women more than dark-skinned women. He also said in an interview that he don't really like black girls like that. This would have been enough to get people angry, but then he added even more fuel to the fire. he said that women with dark skin are too tough, and that light-skinned women, we can break them down more easy. After getting a lot of negative feedback, Kodak deleted his social media accounts. Then, in 2019, he made pretty much the whole industry mad after he said he would wait to have sex with Lauren London, the girlfriend of Nipsey Hussle, who had just got killed a few days earlier. Kodak hopped on Instagram Live and said, "I'll give her a whole year. She might need a whole year to be crying and shit for him." There was a massive backlash immediately. Rappers like T.I. and The Game called him out, and fans on social media made it clear they wasn't cool with the comments. Kodak posted an apology afterwards and said, "If I disrespected you, Lauren London, in any shape or form, I am sorry, even though I didn't."
"If I disrespected you, Lauren London, in any shape or form, I'm sorry, even though I didn't."
It ain't been all bad news for him, though. Over the years, Kodak's been involved with several philanthropy projects and obviously likes to give back to his community. In 2018, he announced he was helping build a school in Haiti. That same year, he helped provide Christmas gifts for 150 kids in his hometown and donated $5,000 for an annual Christmas party. He also donated $2,500 to the family of a South Carolina police officer who was killed on duty. In 2019, he found out about a girl who was trying to give pencils and notebooks to 7,600 kids in a low-income school district. Kodak donated $12,500 to the cause and helped raise enough money for over 40,000 pencils. Even though he was kicked out of school in the fifth grade, education is obviously important to Kodak. He earned his GED in 2018 while in prison. And in 2021, he announced that he would cover the tuition costs for the children of two FBI agents who were killed on duty. Kodak has had a crazy life full of ups and downs, and now he's been involved in another wild situation. But even though he was shot, it seems like the injuries ain't too bad and he'll be back on the street soon. This story's still developing, so tap in for updates.